This problem, we have a liquid phase continuous stirred tank reactor, and we're given the feed concentration of reactant A, and the reactant is dissolved in water, so the majority concentration of feed is water. We're also given the exit temperature, which means the temperature of the reactor also. And then we have the reaction rate data as a plot shown here, so we have the data of minus the rate of A as a function of the concentration of A. And then we're getting information on heat capacities, heat of reaction, and the heat transfer coefficient times the area for heat transfer. So we have two questions we want to answer. What volumetric flow rate in the feed will result in an outlet concentration of B of 4 moles per liter? And then what coolant temperature do we need to obtain this outlet concentration, which corresponds to converting 80% of A to B? So the first thing we want to do is draw a diagram, label the information that we know. So I've drawn representation of a continuous stirred tank reactor, labeled the information that we know. The concentration of B leaving is 4, which means the concentration of A is 1 mole per liter. And of course, this is also the concentration in the reactor. And the unknowns are the temperature of the coolant and the volumetric flow rate. First thing we can do, since we know the concentration of A in the reactor, and we know the reactor is at 370, that means we could read off what the rate of reaction is. So minus R sub A is equal to 0.02 moles per liter per minute. And of course, the rate's constant in a CSTR. So I'm going to calculate first the volumetric flow rate, and we're going to do that by using a material balance. And we'll do a balance on the reactant A. It's at steady state, so there's no accumulation. There's molar flow rate. This is moles per time, moles per minute flowing in. Molar flow rate out. And then the rate of reaction of A times the volume of the reactor. And we could also write this as the volumetric flow rate, which we don't know, coming into the reactor. Concentration of A. And we're going to assume liquid phase that the volumetric flow rate leaving is the same, concentration of A. And we know the rate of reaction and the volume. So the only thing, since we know this, 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 and this, we can solve for V0. So substituting into the equation, so we can solve for the volumetric flow rate, and this is 5 liters per minute. So that's the first part of the problem. The second part then is to determine the temperature of the coolant. So that means we're going to need an energy balance. And I'm going to write this again as there's no accumulation. We have a term to account for the fact we have to heat up the feed coming in. And the feed consists of reactant A as well as water. And of course the water is much larger concentration, so a larger molar flow rate. And then we have heat of reaction term, rate of reaction times volume, and then the heat transfer coefficient, the area, the coolant temperature, which we're solving for, minus the reactor temperature. So we're going to do is substitute the numbers into this equation. So if I solve this for the coolant temperature, three significant figures at 335 Kelvin. That's the temperature we need in order to get this conversion for this volumetric flow rate.